decided to contribute my quota to making this world a better place for us. And in doing so, I am motivated by Jesus' command, go ye into the world and make disciples of me, preach the gospel, lay your hands upon the sick. When you pray for them, they shall recover. When they step on serpents, it shall not hurt them. You cannot say, God be with you, peace be with you, when you cannot follow that with actionable acts of faith, of providing what you have to provide. I can still hear them
say, oh. Is there anybody out there listening? And does anybody know my name? No, my friend, we were not there, but we're here and we care. And yes, we feel your pain. We feel your pain.
I can't imagine how you felt.
In the last 12, 15 years, by the grace of God, I have led the Royalhouse Chapel organization and churches across this world to target our resources to meet the needs of people who are homeless, people who are hungry, people who have nothing to eat, sometimes before they go to bed, people who are sick, people who are vulnerable, people who are clever and intelligent, but they have nobody to sponsor them to go to school. As a result of this, many of young people and young women end up committing crimes that have ended them up in prisons. This is why we started the prison ministry under our compassion ministry. Under the prisons ministry, I lead a contingent of sometimes 100, 150 member team, and we go to the prisons comprising of doctors, nurses, counselors, prayer warriors, preachers, and so on, with cooked food to go and serve these brothers and sisters of ours, eat with them, love them, show them the other side of the world. That if society has rejected them, if society created the opportunity for them to end up where they are, there is another opportunity that is being created by God through us for the demonstration of His love, so that they will come to the saving knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ. Oh.